Good morning. Welcome. And everybody's got a seat. Good, good, good. Come on in and have a seat. We're so glad that you're here this morning. Many of you are visiting. You're wanting to know, how did Brother Yoon end up at Colonial Presbyterian Church? That is a great question. I'm glad you asked. You know, I was on a mission trip to India in February, and a bunch of elders went with me, and one of them brought this book called The Heavenly Man. And he read it on the plane on the way over. And then another elder read it on the way back. And that happened to be the clerk of our session, Jim Cannon. And we got back, and he handed the book. He pushed it in my chest and said, "You need to read this book." And I started reading that book as soon as we got back. And I'm telling you what, I could not put it down. And many of you have had a chance to read Brother Yoon's story. It is not a book written by Brother Yoon. It's written in the first person, but a person who heard about his story insisted that it get written down. Brother Yoon is a very modest man. But we're grateful that he did share his story, because it opens our eyes to the world of the persecuted church. And that is a world that we now know in living color is going on in places like Iraq and Syria. But it's always been going on. And so after finishing the book, come back to my story, it was midnight. And I looked at the very last page, and there was a website. So I went to the website for this great ministry, and I saw that Brother Yoon was going to be in the United States, but he did not have Kansas City on his itinerary. So I went to the, you know, the contact us button, and I clicked it, and I wrote an email. And I said, "I don't see how you can come to the United States and not come to the greatest city in the entire United States. You're going to be coming somewhere close by, because we're right in the middle. And you really need to come and share your story here in Kansas City. And I think you should come and do it right here at Colonial Presbyterian Church." It's one of those things that you do at midnight. It sounds like a great idea. And I thought, I'll probably never. And they, Brother Eugene wrote me the very next day, said, "You know what? We were just talking with a site in Topeka for our Saturday stop. Why don't we come on Sunday the 12th? I said, "That'll work." So we have been so blessed. Next week, we have David Yegnazar coming, who will be talking about the persecuted church in Iran. But today, we get the great privilege of hearing from Brother Yoon. We're so grateful for his perseverance, his endurance, and his testimony. Brother Wren will be his translator, and he will come and share for just a minute after the video. That will kind of introduce you to Brother Yoon and his ministry, and then we'll hear from Brother Yoon for the remainder of the service. So can we just give him a warm welcome right quick? We just love you. We're so glad you're here.
Wonderful to be here in such an important church. We did not know when we walked in that this is the most important church in entire United States. We must have been fooled in Saddleback and any other churches. This must be the place. Now, as you discover, I do not speak English. I only imitate people who speak English. I was born in Finland, so I'm all Finnish from the beginning. But about 32 years ago, God led our family to China, and we've been living there since that. And there I met the speaker of this morning. About 22 years ago, we met somewhere in China, actually in man-made cave. And that was beginning of our partnership today, as we are traveling and sharing to everybody what God is doing in China and from China. Now, this may not be surprise you, but have you heard that the blood of Jesus is now washing the whole China, and millions of people are coming to Jesus Christ? Have you heard that every month, at least 1 million people in China make a decision, "I want to follow Jesus"? And today, the combined church, the official church, the registered church, and the underground churches, which represent the majority, they are more than 160 million disciples of Jesus Christ in mainland China. These are government secret figures. And this is what they predict. Within 15 to 20 years, if the church growth continues like this, there will be 400 million followers of Jesus Christ in mainland China. And what does that mean? Did you know that about a week ago, the Chinese economy became the number one economy in the world? Did you know that already last year, Mandarin Chinese became the most used language on the internet? Our challenge today is, as believers, how do we get enough Word of God to these people? How are we able to help them to develop their mission? So back to Jerusalem is simply the Chinese Chinese Great Commission. They believe that God has raised this church to be a launching pad, to send people to all these regions between China and Jerusalem. Two-thirds of world population live inside that window. 9 out of 10 people who never have heard the gospel, they live between China and Jerusalem. And the Chinese now see that God has given the Central Asia and the Middle East as a spiritual inheritance for us. The door is closed for you and I to long-term do anything in those countries, but the door is wide open for Chinese to go. And now the church have started this already about 8 years ago. We started in a little tiny country, North Korea. There have been so many mission resources being put to help the starving people in North Korea. But nobody so far have succeeded to share the gospel to North Koreans. But when the Chinese missionaries, I remember the first Chinese missionary. She was 22 years old, little tiny girl. And she had a plastic bag in her hands when she walked across the border into North Korea. She had been trained in the language and culture. And within 1 year, she led more than 6,000 North Koreans to Jesus Christ inside North Korea. Is this God or somebody else? It's a good place to say amen. And it continues again and ongoingly. And now what we try to do, that we get Bible. It's a birthright for every believer. I have to have Word of God. And do you understand the danger? If you don't have a Word of God, what will happen in any country? So that's what we do. And thank you very much allowing us to come and share what God is doing. The other country where the Chinese are already, I know that this church you love, Iran. I've been in Iran many times, and the most amazing thing is happening, that the underground church is growing. Every week, thousands of people receive Jesus Christ inside Iran. And now the greatest challenge is, how do we get the Word of God to those new believers? And let me show you the present version of the Iranian Bible. I have it right here. This is the adapter. The Bible is actually here. It's a little tiny SD microcard, and this has everything they need in order to survive and grow in their Christian faith and the purpose of their lives. And I have good news. These are all produced inside Iran today by Chinese missionaries. We have a capacity to bake. We call these places digital Bible bakeries. And we are able to produce 100,000 Bibles every month inside Iran for the needs of the church. So whatever God put into your heart to donate to this work, every dollar will unredacted go into this to get the Word of God to these places. And the third country where we are working right now is the northern part of Iraq. God has given us this crazy idea. Not only that we should look after those people groups who have been forced to leave their security and become refugees, and now they are open for the gospel because they are not where they used to be before. But also, we have a determination that ISIS will hear the gospel of Jesus Christ. And the only Chinese missionaries are able to survive in that environment. There's nobody else. And that's what we are doing. So back to Jerusalem, it's God's calling for his church. And we have one of these brothers here today, my blood brother and partner, Heavenly Man. Let's welcome Heavenly Man, and he will share his message.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord. 伸出你的手对你身边说耶稣爱你
And now with fluent Chinese, say to one another, 耶稣爱你 It means Jesus loves you.
Yeah.
耶稣爱你
Amen.
耶稣爱你
耶稣爱你 Jesus loves you.
Amen.
Yeah. Jesus loves you. Amen.
Amen.
耶稣爱你 Chinese
is the world's most simple language, so I will just teach you so that you remember these key words.
Yesu is Jesus.
So Yesu, that is Jesus.
I is English love.
I
this is the I, this is the ni.
Okay. Yesu I ni. Okay.
1, 2, 3.
Yesu I ni.
每一个人都可以成为一个向中国人传福音的
Now you are all qualified to be messengers of the gospel to every Chinese you meet anywhere.
Hallelujah. 我来到这里的时候，有一句主的话语要给你们。
When I came here this church this morning, the Lord gave me a word to share with you this morning.
在约翰福音21章一开始就说，这是以后耶稣又向门徒们显现。
And it's from a book of Gospel of John 21, where it says, afterward Jesus appeared again to his disciples by the Sea of Galilee.
他向门徒们显现的第一句话就是说，又向门徒们显现的第一句话就是说，小子们，你们有吃力吗？
And the first words he spoke to his disciples that morning was, he said, "Friends," or Chinese Bible said, "Children, haven't you any fish or anything to eat?"
耶稣向门徒显现的时候，他是在寻找他的敌人。他的门徒们在不久的时候都是背叛了他，离开了他。可是耶稣来了，在关心他。Jesus
demonstrated his love and compassion towards his disciples, and he wanted to take care of their needs.
我想这个故事已经牧师给我们讲过很多次，大家可能已经读过很多次了。
I know that you have been studying this Bible passage many times, and your pastors have been delivering excellent messages from this passage.
这是之前门徒们不管是有伤心、有失败、有得胜、有软弱，可是这是以后耶稣的显现有一个新的改变，就一句话。
Now this was after many things. The failures, after the victories, and the time, many years of fellowship with Jesus, it says, afterwards, after all that has been happening in the past, Jesus again appeared to his disciples.
耶稣的一句话，人开始照那一句话去行的时候，故事告诉我们说，那越往下去的时候，那个鱼是拉不动的。
And the Bible tells that when Jesus said to his disciples, throw your nets into the water, that they catch an amazing big number of fish that morning.
依照主的话语下网的时候，不但从那个海里上来的时候有鱼有活，而且他们在数算那个鱼的时候是153条大鱼，网没有破。
And it's written in the Bible that after they counted, there were 153 fish. And then when they came back to the shore, they saw there was a fire, and there were some other fish already there in the fire.
我想问牧师刚刚来读《天上人》这本书，他放不下。你们中间有没有人读过这本书？
Now, are there any other besides your pastor who have read my life story, Heavenly Man? Can you raise up hand?
这么多人已经读过这个故事。Amazing,
where did you get it? So many have read that story.
在主患难国度人那里，我和你们是一同有份的。我的名字叫天上人。I'm
called Heavenly Man, Brother Yun, and I'm one of your brothers. who have been unified with you in suffering and in the kingdom of God.
我十七岁遇见耶稣以后，在中国这个国家被判刑过，被关过很多次监牢，判刑过十四年，有十年的时间在监牢里。
When I was 16 years old, Jesus came to my life. He called me to be his witness and go to west and south. And when in obedience to that calling, I started to share the gospel.I became a wanted criminal. I was arrested more than 30 times, and four times in my life I was sentenced to prison.
我为了福音的缘故，经历过死荫的幽谷，可以确实地说，为了福音的缘故，当经他受逼迫的时候，我的灵魂离开我，往天上去过。
And during the time in these special prisons in torture.It happened several times that the pain was so horrible that my spirit left my body.
我第一次在监牢的时候，当我醒来的时候，我不想回来。我说主啊，我不想回来，我想回家。我听到主在告诉我说，孩子，你为我受的苦我知道，我要给你一个敞开的门，是没有人能关的。
I remember.In the beginning of my first imprisonment, when in the torture, the pain was so horrible that when my spirit left my body, I said, Jesus, I want to come home today. I don't want to return back to that pain anymore. And immediately I heard Jesus saying, My son, I know all the pain you are going through right now. See, I am going to open a door for you no man is able to shut.
这都是在这之前的事情。神呼召我的时候，他告诉我说，云弟兄，你起来向西，向南，传福音做见证，也就是把福音传回耶路撒冷。
The calling that I received from the Lord as a 16-year-old boy was to be his witness to west and south all the way back to Jerusalem.
可是我一直在监牢的那么多年，我经历过神，我也听见过主给我说话的声音。
All these years that I spent in the prisons,I had many wonderful experiences about his presence and how he was communicating and speak to me as I was in the prison.
可是第三次为了福音的缘故是在1997年的时候，就是为了这个福音传回耶路撒冷的意象正在聚集的时候，又被抓进到监牢里。
But then 1997, I was again arrested in China.And this was the most severe because we had a meeting among the leaders of different house church networks. How do we bring fulfillment to this vision to bring the gospel back to Jerusalem? And that was the subject we were discussing as leaders when the authority surrounded the place and all the leaders were arrested.
弟兄姊妹，我告诉你们，我不是一个完全的人。我也不是一个二十四个小时都非常熟灵超奇的人。
And I just want to tell the truth for you this morning. I'm not a 24/7 super believer and follower of Jesus.
我第三次被关进监牢的时候，我的妻子也被关进监牢里，我的同工们也被关进监牢，但是我的两条腿也被打断了。
Now this third time was the most severe.They captured my wife, and she was thrown to another prison for female prisoners. And then they arrested all my closest co-workers, and we were sent into a top security prison. And then in torture, they crushed both my legs from ankles with sledgehammer, and they said, "You're never going to walk with these legs. You are going to stay in this prison rest of your life."
所以前不久有好几个朋友把那个伊朗基督徒被杀的时候，那个头被割掉，那个一刹那那个照片给我的时候，我看见那个照片，我开始跪下来就开始哭。我说主啊，你在你仆人身上做的事，我求你在伊朗，在伊拉克。
And just about a few weeks ago, as we have been working in northern Iraq, And all these horrible pictures started to come, how ISIS is killing children, cutting off their head and playing football with their heads. And when I saw those pictures, I went on my knees and I said, Lord, when is your kingdom going to come upon Middle East and Central Asia?
虽然不是在割头，他们做有一些事情是远超过我们所想象的那种痛苦。
It was horrible pain I have to go through, but I identified myself with those people who saw what happened to their children, and I was crying to the Lord.
当我两条腿打断以后，我说神呐，为什么？我错在哪里？ 我的黑夜什么时候会过去？中国的天什么时候会亮啊？
And when I was in the prison, I said, Lord, what did I do wrong? Why did you allow this to happen? And then I said, Lord, when is the light of your gospel to shine fully over my nation of China? And a new day will dawn.
我告诉弟兄们，我像耶稣的门徒一样，我对耶稣的降生受死，我见过耶稣的复活的大能，可是面临着我自己的这个处境，我不知道该怎么面对。I
had in the past strong experience about power of the name Jesus. I have seen him do wonderful miracles and things in China. But when my personal situation was like this, I did not know what to think and what to believe.
我真的想要放弃我的生命，不是放弃我的信仰，想要放弃我的护照。我也没有想到我还能够从监牢里活出来。
I could hardly believe that the day would come that they would release me from prison anymore, and I was ready to quit my calling and my ministry. Not my faith to Jesus, but just my ministry that has caused all this pain to my life.
我在大声喊叫的时候，连那个看守人员都说这个传道人疯了，他现在开始在质问上帝。
And I was crying in my solitary cell. I was crying to God aloud in such a way that all the warden, they came to outside of my cell. And they were saying, look at this preacher, he has lost his mind, and he's so upset on his
God.那时候很多看守人员围过来说，我们早就告诉你没有上帝，你说耶稣是活着的，你现在自己都怀疑了吧。
And they reminded me, they said that we have told you from the beginning that your God does not exist. So obviously when he doesn't exist, he cannot help you. So, now you start to believe that yourself. Obviously, you don't believe that your Jesus loves you and your Jesus can set you free because you are in this cell.
就在我人生最低谷的时候，我突然间听到主对我来讲，云弟兄，你转过身去。
And then I heard Jesus saying something, like, turn around 180 degrees and fix your eyes upon me.
当我开始转过来，身体的我仍然里面那个声音在跟那抱怨的时候，突然间主的话临到我说说：“当你耶和华是我所谓的盾牌，是我的荣耀。”And
immediately when I turned around, my spirit started to sing a Bible verse. Lord, you are my rock, you are my fortress, and you will lift me up from my pit.
我感受到神在对我说话。And
I was so amazed. The Lord is again communicating with me through his word.
耶稣向我显现的一刹那，所有的恐惧，所有的沮丧，所有的那个绝望，所有的东西都离开了。And
the amazing thing happens whenever Jesus speaks to us. All the fear is gone, and the presence of his peace will come into our lives. And I experienced that morning.
当时看守人员看我在那里欢呼，在那里唱的时候说：“这个人真正是疯了，没有办法了。”
And the authorities were still standing on the other side of my cell, And then I had been upset on God. Then I turned around, and now I was singing praises to God. And they said, "Oh, that is really true. He's totally gone crazy."
我就抓住神的话语，大声地在喊叫的时候，当人没有人理你的时候，你记住，耶稣他仍然在你的身边，在你们的诗歌里面。
I experienced in that moment that when nobody cares about you.And the whole world is against you. There is one who is always faithful, and he is Jesus.
那个时候，我都听到主在对我说：“云弟兄，你的天已经亮了，那个门已经开了，你现在起来走。”
And then the Lord said to me, "Brother Un, now is a new day for you. It's now dawning. All the doors have been opened for you.Stand up and walk out from your cell.
我的经历告诉你，神给你一个意象，神会有他自己的办法来完成他给你的意象。
Now I have to help you to understand this. If God gives you a command to do something, He has His way to make it happen. It's not your responsibility.
当主呼唤说门开了，你起来走那一刹那，我的心中就开始咚咚在跳动，说：“主啊，这是监牢，我不是在做梦了。”
When I heard him saying, "Stand up and walk out from the prison," my heart was beating so hard, and I said, "Lord, this is a top security prison. You don't walk out places like this."
弟兄姊妹，神认识我们的时候，比我们自己还认识我们自己。
I have good news for you. The Lord knows us better than we know ourselves.
我正是开始在思想这是监牢的时候，又有一句话进入到我的里面：监狱是实实，但我是真理呢。门开了，起来走。
When I was replying to Jesus, "This is a prison. You don't walk out from there." Immediately he responded.Your prison is real, but I'm the truth, and the truth will set you free.
Hallelujah. 当我开始顺服神
and as I started to obey God,
那个警察没四道天门，没有一个人在问我说你往哪里去。我好像就从这里在经过。
I passed four double gates inside the prison with guards.With AK-47 in their hands, nobody asked the most logical question: Where is the crippled man walking today?
他那个走到最后一道门，那个门就是这样开始开开的时候，一个出租车在那里往哪里去
Then I passed the prison yard. 30 policemen were standing there. It was 8 o'clock in the morning. The night shift turned to the day shift. Nobody saw me. Nobody asked anything. I walked to the main gates, and they were opened supernaturally for me. And Jesus had ordered a taxi, so it was waiting for me outside.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
我坐在那个车上的时候，就有一句话语临到我说，我是那透过那个出租车那个司机的一个钥匙说。我是圣洁真实，我拿着大卫的钥匙，我开了，没有人能关。
And as I was sitting on the back seat of that speeding taxi, God started to speak to me through a key that was hanging from a chain and from the mirror of the taxi. And this is what the Holy Spirit said.I am the Holy One and the Truly One. I have the keys of David in my hands. The doors I open, no man is able to shut.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
我今天不是叫你单单听我的故事，我渴望每一个人，你也能够，不管你在什么样的环境中，你真的需要耶稣再一次向你显现。
And the purpose why I'm sharing my testimony this morning.Is that you, you would be filled with faith that no matter what is your circumstances this morning, Jesus is the solution. He will set you free. Amen.
Hallelujah. 当主耶稣显现那一刹那，在那个车上，好像我要飞起来似的，好像所有的大山，都所有的困难，在我们好像没算不得什么。
You can hardly believe what I felt in my spirit when I had been healed and I was sitting on the back seat of the taxi. It was like I was flying, and suddenly all the mountains between me and Jerusalem, all the difficulties, challenges, they just was wiped away, and I understood Jesus have keys in his hands.
Oh, 主啊，是你，是主。那个
时候
对那个回归耶路撒冷那个意象来讲的话，没有是不可能的。主能开中国监牢的门，印度教的门要开，穆斯林地区的门要开，宗教的门要开。
And my faith for the fulfillment of the Great Commission and the back to Jerusalem was more than 100-fold. I understand that God is going to open the doors into the Buddhist world, into the Hindu world, and into Islamic world. Nothing is going to hold back the power of gospel of Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
我再次能够真实地经历到天上地下所有的权柄都在他手里。
And for my one ear, I heard a amplifier sending a message. All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, you go and make all the ethnicities to my disciple.
我仿佛看见不但是中国的门开了，我仿佛看见中东地区的门要为这个中国人来开始要打开了。
And I saw with my spiritual eyes something happening. God started to open the doors out from China towards West.And I saw simple Chinese believers moving like a river into the Buddhist world, into Hindu world, all the way to the Islamic world. And nothing was able to stop that outflow of presence of God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
神是信实的，对某些国家中东的门虽然关注了，但是对华人来讲的话，今年我们很多次去到中东地区。巴基斯坦、
Asia,
叙利亚、南苏丹，整个这个门开始在开。
Is more and more being closed for Western white-skin, high-nose missionaries. It is wide open for Chinese to go, and we have to make sure that they have a possibility to expand the kingdom of God.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
我过去告诉过布什一句话语，我说。你可以派军队把伊拉克、伊朗、阿富汗平掉，但是人的心需要神的话。我说我的渴望是要把圣经带进中东。
We were invited to have a meeting with George W. Bush Jr. and his wife, and we said to him that you can set the soldiers and your army to destroy your enemies, but you are not able to change.The hearts of the people with your weapons.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
神给中国教会的意象是渴望你的配搭，你愿意为中国，为主神的国降临在中东祷告祝福吗？
God has given this vision to His church in China, and while we are here this morning, we just want to challenge you. Would you mind?To pray for these young Chinese missionaries as they are now going all over that region and these countries and start to expand the kingdom of God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
如果你愿意和异样里来祝福神的国降临在中东，我渴望你和我一同站起来，我们一起为中东地区祷告。
And if you have this desire in your heart.And you said, I have to start to pray that kingdom of God will come upon Middle East and Central Asia. I would love you to join me, together with me, in a prayer. Let us cry out to God for Middle East and Central Asia.
当然我也很渴望能够为你为着今天来的弟兄姊妹，我能够感受到游历人，你虽然是在一个自由的世界，我发现游历人是在一个苦读抱怨或者是在一个癌症那个里面，那个监牢里面一直你出不来。
And even if there would be one person who is sitting here this morning and you recognize that I'm not fully free, maybe there are some difficulties in your lifeOr maybe you are sick. I also want to bless you all in this closing prayer.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
多少人和我一样渴望今天早上主耶稣向你显现。
Do you have a prayer in your heart? I want to meet Jesus this morning.
Yeah.
Amen. Jesus said to his disciples,
小子们, 你们有吃力吗?
Do you have something to eat?
他今天早上在问你, 小子们, 你心中有平安吗?
你有喜乐吗? He is asking us this morning, do you have my peace in your heart?
你需要我的医治吗?
Do you want me to touch your life?
你的家人都认识我了吗?
So that everyone in your family will come. Can we stand up together and I will close in the prayer? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Resurrected Lord Jesus, we thank you that you are with us in this morning service.
主啊,你认识你的羊,你的羊也认识你的声音。
I thank you that you know all your sheep and your sheep recognize your voice.
你知道今天早上有很多人真正是面临着像门徒的处境一样,在一种灰心、沮丧、绝望之中。
Lord, you know the situation in our hearts and what is going on in our lives.
我们今天早上真的渴望能够听到你的声音。
And we desperately need you to speak to us again and again.
叫我们能够听到主你对我们说中东地区的门开了，穆斯林地区的门要开了，这个地区的门也要开了。 And
you want to increase our faith to believe that the doors for the gospel will be opened all these countries in Central Asia and Middle East.
弟兄姊妹，我们现在一同开口为主神，在我们这个地区，在美国的门，为主神在中东地区的门，我们大家一同开口祷告。And
let us all pray together for the country of America, that this nation will find a way back to resurrected Lord Jesus. Let us together pray for this. Heavenly Father, this morning we want to pray for America. We want to pray for your church in this country, that once again your church will arise and stand up for righteousness and stand up for your truth and really get involved with what you are doing within this generation. And I thank you, we thank you for what you have been sharing with us this morning. May that become like a seed of faith in our hearts. We do not understand your ways, but we do recognize our God is in action and the gospel is spreading out all over those parts of the world who never have heard the gospel. Thank you, Lord, that you bless each one of them, and may they rejoice in that salvation they have received through the blood of Jesus Christ. Amen. Mm-hmm.